Hello friends, this is my first lecture on jet transforms. So in this lecture we shall discuss the jet transform and inverse jet transform of some elementary functions. The jet transforms are useful in solving difference equations which arise in the discrete systems. The development of the communication branch of engineering is actually based on the theory of jet transforms. The jet transform has the same role in discrete systems as the Laplace transform in continuous systems. Many properties of the jet transforms are similar to the properties of the Laplace transforms. Jet transform operates on a sequence un of discrete integer valued arguments n equal to 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2 and so on, unlike the Laplace transform which operates on continuous functions. Jet transform is, we can say, is the discrete analog of the Laplace transform. For every operational rule and application of Laplace transform, there is an operational rule and application of jet transforms. A discrete system can be expressed as a difference equation and then its solution can be obtained by using jet transforms. So let us see how we define the jet transforms. The jet transform of the sequence un defined for discrete values n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, and un equal to 0 for n less than 0 is denoted by z un and is defined as z un equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity un z to the power minus n, which is a function of z. So we write it as uz, provided the infinite series converges. So whenever this infinite series converges, it will give us a function of z. So it is uz. The inverse z transform is written as z inverse of uz, z inverse of uz equal to un. So whenever we know the z transform of a sequence, its inverse z transform will give us back the sequence un, like in the case of the Laplace transform we define the inverse Laplace transform. Here again the inverse z transform is defined in a similar manner. So z inverse uz equal to un. Now let us discuss z transforms of some standard sequences. So let us begin with un equal to a to the power n. So when un is a to the power n, then where a is a complex number, then z of a to the power n is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity. So un here is a to the power n, so n equal to 0 to infinity un z to the power minus n. So we have a to the power n and z to the power minus n. This capital Z, this is small z. Now this is summation n equal to 0 to infinity a by z raised to the power n. Now we know that here z is a complex number, a is a complex constant. So a by z is a complex number. So the series of complex numbers sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a by z to the power n converges, provided mod of z a by z is less than 1, and we have this is equal to 1 over 1 minus a by z, provided mod of a by z is less than 1. So this gives you z over z minus a, provided mod of a by z is less than 1 or mod of z is greater than mod of a. So the condition for the convergence of the series here is that mod of z must be greater than mod of a. And now let us look at the formula, which is known as the recurrence formula. If you take un to be n to the power p, let us say un equal to n to the power p, where p is a positive integer, then we have z of n to the power p. This formula is very useful in determining the z transforms of other sequences. So minus z d over dz of z n to the power p minus 1. Okay, so here what do we let us prove this formula. Okay, so to prove this formula, we have z of n to the power p. Z of n to the power p by definition is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n to the power p z to the power minus n. Okay, so we have this, we have given here the proof. This can be written as z times summation n equal to 0 to infinity n to the power p minus 1 into n into z to the power minus n plus 1. Now, since by definition z of n to the power p minus 1 is equal to summation n equal to 0 to infinity n to the power p minus 1 z to the power minus n, we have d over dz of z n to the power p minus 1 equal to summation n equal to 0 to infinity n to the power p minus 1 into minus n z to the power minus n plus 1. Okay. Now, let us combine this equation 1 and 2. So, when you combine 1 and 2, what you find is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n to the power p minus 1 into n into z to the power minus n plus 1, that is z of n to the power p. So, we get z of n to the power p, okay, equal to minus z into d over dz of n to the power p minus 1. So, combining 1 and 2, we have the required recurrence relation from here. So, z of n to the power p is minus z d over dz z of n to the power p minus 1. Now, this result is going to be very useful in finding the z transforms of some other sequences. Let us first look at the special cases of result z of a to the power n equal to z over z minus a. So here, if you take a equal to 1, we will have see, if you take, let us say we take, let a be equal to 1, then u 1 is equal to 1 for all n, and z of u n is equal to z of 1 will be equal to z over z minus 1 from this result. So, this is valid when mod of z is greater than 1. So, z of 1 can be found from z of a to the power n equal to z over z minus a by taking a equal to 1. So, let us see how we find z of n equal to z over z minus 1 whole square. So, let us use this result. So, let us take p equal to 1 in the recurrence result. In the recurrence formula, so then z of n to the power p, that we are taking p equal to 1. So, z of n equal to minus z d over dz of z to the power n to the power 0, which is 1, and z of 1 we have found just now, which is minus z d over dz of, so d over dz of z over z minus 1. Okay. Let us differentiate z over z minus 1 with respect to z. So, d over dz of z over z minus 1, we can write it as d over dz of z minus 1 plus 1 divided by z minus 1, which is equal to d over dz of 1 plus 1 upon z minus 1. So, when we differentiate this, we get minus 1 upon z minus 1 whole square, and thus Z of the sequence U n equal to n is minus Z into minus 1 upon Z minus 1 whole square, which gives you Z over Z minus 1 whole square. So, that is how we find Z of the sequence U n equal to n. Then next you can find Z of U n equal to n square in a similar manner. So, Z of n square. Now, in the recurrence formula we take p equal to 2. So, we shall have in the recurrence formula take p equal to 2. So, Z of n square is minus Z d over dz of Z of n, and Z of n we have already found. So, minus Z d over dz of Z n is Z over Z minus 1 whole square. So, by differentiating this result, okay, by differentiating d z over z minus 1 whole square, we shall have one derivative z is 1 into z minus 1 whole square minus z into 2 times z minus 1 divided by z minus 1 to the power 4. So, we can cancel z minus 1, and then what do we get? Minus z times z minus 1 minus 2 z upon z minus 1 to the power 3. So, what do we get? This is minus z minus 1. So, z square plus z divided by z minus 1 whole to the power 3. So, we get the formula for n square, which is z square plus z over z minus 1 whole cube. Now, we can find find the value of z n cube in a similar manner by taking p equal to 3 in the recurrence formula. We will need the value of z n square, which we have already found. So, by differentiating the value of z n square and multiplying by minus z, we shall arrive at the formula for z n cube, which is z cube plus 4 z square plus z over z minus 1 to the power 4, and so on. So, this is how we find the z transforms of these sequences u n equal to 1, u n equal to n, u n equal to n square, u n equal to n cube. And then we can see that if we want to find the inverse z transform, then inverse z transform of z over z minus 1, z inverse of z over z minus 1 will be equal to 1. So, the inverse z transform of z over z minus 1 will be u n equal to 1 for all n equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on, and 0 for n less than 0. Okay, so now let us go to the properties of the Z transform. We know that in the Laplace transform we have the linearity property. So, here also we have the linearity property. If a and b are any complex constants, real or complex constants, and u n and b n are two sequences defined on the discrete arguments, then z of a u n plus v v n equal to a z u n plus b z v b n. This we can easily prove by the definition of the z transform. Z of a u n plus b v n will be equal to summation n equal to 0 to infinity a u n plus b v n into z to the power minus n, which can be broken as summation n equal to 0 to infinity a u n z to the power minus n plus summation n equal to 0 to infinity b v n into z to the power minus n, and which is equal to a times summation n equal to 0 to infinity u n z to the power minus n plus summation b times summation n equal to 0 to infinity b n z to the power minus n, and this is a times z u n plus b times z b n. So, z transforms satisfy the linearity property, and then we have the change of scale property. If you remember, we have the change of scale property in the Laplace transforms. So, here we also we have the change of scale property. If z of the sequence u n is given by u z, then z of a to the power minus n u n is equal to u a z. This can be proved very easily. Let us write z of a to the power minus n u n. By definition, this will be sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a to the power minus n u n into z to the power minus n, and this can be then written further as sigma n equal to 0 to infinity u n into a z to the power minus n. Now, by our definition, z of u n is summation n equal to 0 to infinity u n z to the power minus n, which we have denoted by u z. So, here we have sigma n equal to 0 to infinity u n a z to the power minus n. So, in place of z we have a z. So, this implies sigma n equal to 0 to infinity u n a z to the power minus n equal to u a u a z. So, that is how we get the change of scale property. Whenever we multiply u n sequence by a to the power minus n, there is a change of scale. In place of z, in u z we get a z, u z becomes u a z. So, now the corollary of this result is z of a to the power n u n equal to u z by a. So, let us see, we have z of, in the damping rule we have z of a to the power minus n u n equal to u a z. Okay. So, this if replacing a by 1 by a, okay, we have z of a to the power n u n equal to u z upon a on replacing a by 1 by a in the damping rule. So, we have z of a to the power n u n equal to u z by a. The geometric factor, let us see, the geometric factor u a to the power minus n, which occurs here, okay, damps the function u n when mod of z is less than 1, and that is why we call it as the damping rule. So, now using this damping rule, z of u n equal to, if z of u n equal to u z, we have z of a to the power minus n u n equal to u a z. Using this damping rule, we can find the z transforms of several other sequences, which will be important when we solve a difference equation. We find the general solution of a difference equation. So, let us see what how we can use this damping rule. From the damping rule, it follows that z of a to the n a to the power n, z of n a to the power n is equal to a z upon z minus a whole square. Let us prove this. We know that from the damping rule, z of a to the power n, z of a to the power n u n is equal to u z by a, where u z is the z transform of the sequence u n. Okay. So, what we do is, in order to prove z of n a to the power n equal to a z over z minus a whole square, let us take u n equal to n. Okay. So, when u n equal to n,
we have
a z over z minus a whole square. So, this is how we find the z transform of the sequence n into a to the power n by using the damping rule. Similarly, we can find the z transform of n square a to the power n. So, we know that z transform of n square, z transform of n square we had obtained earlier, it is z square plus z over n z minus 1 whole cube. Okay. So, we apply the damping rule again, applying the damping rule. z of a to the power n into u n equal to u z by a. Okay, where u z is sigma, u z is z transform of u n sequence. Okay. So, let u n be equal to n square, then z transform of n square, then u z is equal to z square plus z divided by z minus 1 whole cube. Okay. So, z transform of n square, u n is n square a to the power n will be replacing z by z over a. So, z by a whole square plus z by a divided by z by a minus 1 whole cube. This will give you a z square plus a square z over this is a square here. So, a square when we multiply a cube we are multiplying, okay, a cube we are multiplying. So, we get a z square over plus a square z over z minus a whole cube. So, that is how we find the z transform of n square into a to the power n. Similarly, you can find the z transform of n cube into a to the power n, because we have found the z transform of n cube. So, once z transform of n cube is known, z transform of n cube into a to the power n will be replaced z by z minus a in the z transform of n cube, and you get the z transform of n cube a to the power n. So, these are some of the standard results that we shall need in the when we solve the difference equations. So, one should memorize in fact these results, because when we solve the difference equation, there we will have to take the inverse z transform. So for taking the inverse jet transform, we need to memorize some of these important results. Like when you take the inverse Laplace transform, you use the known results of Laplace transforms of some standard functions. Similarly here, so we need to memorize some of these standard results to take the inverse jet transform while solving the difference equations. So with that, I would like to conclude my lecture. I thank you very much for your attention.